हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू डायमंड ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशंस ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। माय सेल्फ गोविंद राव, सीनियर लेक्चरर इन मैथमेटिक्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द चैप्टर डिटरमिनेंट्स। दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 11। यस, टोटली वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द टोटल 10 लेक्चर्स इन दिस। यस, सो नाउ वी आर टेकिंग द इंपॉर्टेंट कांसेप्ट इन दिस, दैट इज ऑर्डर ऑफ अ मैट्रिक्स। ऑर्डर ऑफ अ मैट्रिक्स व्हिच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एनसीईआरटी एज वेल एज जेईई मेंस आल्सो। रिमेंबर फॉर सीईटी आल्सो, यस, ऑर्डर ऑफ अ मैट्रिक्स एंड इनवर्स ऑफ अ मैट्रिक्स बोथ आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। सो नाउ वी कैन स्टार्ट हाउ टू फाइंड द ऑर्डर ऑफ अ मैट्रिक्स। सपोज ही इज गिविंग द 2x2 मैट्रिक्स एंड फॉर द 3x3 मैट्रिक्स आल्सो। आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ दिस कॉन्सेप्ट, आफ्टर दैट वी विल टेक द इनवर्स ऑफ अ मैट्रिक्स। यस, सो नाउ ऑफ द हियर we are taking the one of the matrix. Say this is the matrix A is having, yes, by taking this matrix A, so in this we are writing the elements. Actually the matrix of order is having here what, 3x3, yes or no? The matrix of order is here what, 3x3, means there are 3 rows are having and 3 columns are having. Yes, so totally 3 rows are there in this, 3 columns are having. Yes, so now we are taking here this matrix. Now I am going to find the adjoint of this matrix A. Yes, sir, how we can find the adjoint of the matrix? Means it is a very simple to find the adjoint of a matrix. Sir, there is a one of the matrix. First we have to find the cofactors of each and every element in a matrix. Yes, suppose I am giving one of the matrix for you people. By taking the matrix A, in that matrix suppose having the order is 3x3, means we are finding the cofactor of each and every element in that matrix. Yes, we know that how to find the cofactor in the previous class we have completed. Now suppose I am giving the element a11, how we will find the cofactor? The cofactor of small a11 is what, capital a11, yes or no? So suppose I am giving one of the element for you people, the a12. Yes, the element is having a12. What is the cofactor for that? That is capital A12. Yes, in place of small letter we have read the word capital A. That's all. That is the cofactor we are going to indicate. So that's why I am taking as the cofactor matrix. Yes, by taking the cofactor matrix, it is a very simple one. Just in place of capital small A, we are going to replace here what, capital A. Again, see, in place of small A, writing here what, capital A. So like that, we are taking here matrix. What is the order of this one again? This is again 3x3 only. Yes. See here, in place of small a, I am writing the capital A. That's all. This is nothing but the cofactor matrix. A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. Yes. So now, after completion of this one, after having the cofactor matrix, so then we have to write the adjoint A. Yes. What is the adjoint A? Adjoint A is nothing but cofactor matrix whole transpose. Remember, to find the adjoint of a matrix, so first we have to find the cofactors of each and every element in the matrix. Yes, by having the cofactors of each and every element in a matrix, suppose there is a cofactor matrix, make the transpose for that. Do you know how to make the transpose? Yes, in the matrix chapter we have completed now how to make the transpose of a matrix. So that's why there is a matrix here, we are writing the cofactor matrix whole transpose. This total, it is nothing but cofactor matrix. Just we are making the transpose for this. The transpose of this cofactor matrix is nothing but what, adjoint of A. That's all. Yes, adjoint of a matrix is nothing but the cofactor matrix whole transpose. Or simply we can say transpose of cofactor matrix is nothing but what, adjoint of matrix. Yes, so that's why I am writing adjoint A is equal to cofactor matrix whole transpose. Yes, this is the cofactor matrix. Now we are making the transpose for this. Now remember, transpose is nothing but what, for the first row we are writing in first column, for the second row we are writing in what, second column, third row we are writing what, third column. The interchanging of rows and columns is nothing but transpose, yes or no? So that's why I am writing the first row in first column, A11, A12, A13, yes, and the second row is A21, A22, A23, next A31, A32, A33. This is nothing but what, adjoint of a matrix. Yes, to find the adjoint of a matrix, suppose he is going to say the matrix is the order 3x3, means it is a very simple. First take a matrix. Yes, in the matrix whatever the 9 elements are there now, so find the cofactors of each and every element in that matrix. So whatever the matrix we are writing after having the cofactors, that is the matrix is known as cofactor matrix. The transpose of the cofactor matrix is nothing but what? Adjoint of a matrix. Yes, this is the way we are finding the adjoint of a matrix. Yes, so after that we will see one of the example also. So after here, the one of the important mode also having here, see, for a square matrix of order 2. Yes, this is the order 3 by 3 we are going to write. Yes, suppose I am giving for you to 2 by 2 matrix. Yes, suppose I am giving the order is 2. Sir, how we can find the adjoint of a matrix means? Again, it is a very very simple one. See, A is the matrix having here. A is equal to A11, A12, A21, A22. Yes, this is the matrix or not? So now, to find the adjoint for this matrix A, if you are finding the adjoint for this matrix A, so remember, adjoint of A is equal to, how we can find the adjoint for this matrix A means, just we are interchanging, yes, we are interchanging these two elements. We are interchanging these two elements, mein interchange ka matlab kya hota hai? Ek dusre ke places mein bitana, yes. So that's why A22 we are taking in place of A11. Yes, A11 we are interchanging in place of what? A22. Dono ko interchange karna chahiye. That's why I am writing here, here you see, interchange. Yes, we are interchanging these two elements. By interchanging these two elements, it is A22, A11. After that, just change the sign of this. Sign kya hota hai? Sign is nothing but plus or minus. So that's why, now we are changing the sign of this. Suppose in front of this we have the positive sign, simply we are writing there what? Negative sign. Okay, so here both is simple. This is the matrix here, remember. For this matrix we are writing the adjoint of a matrix. Just we have to interchange these two places. Yes, again just we have to change the sign of this. So then that is the matrix known as what? Adjoint of a matrix A. Yes, this is nothing but the 2 by 2 matrix we are finding. So once again I will recall. So suppose he is giving the 3 by 3 matrix. First we have to find the cofactors of each and every element in the matrix. After having the cofactor matrix, just we have to make the transpose for the cofactor matrix. The transpose of cofactor matrix is known as what? Adjoint of a matrix. Yes, this is the process we are doing up to here. This is the way we are doing in the 3 by 3 matrix. Suppose if I give the 2 by 2 matrix for you people, so observe the now how to find the adjoint of the matrix for the 2 by 2 matrix means, just we have to interchange these two places. Yes, and next change the sign of these two places. That's sign ka matlab plus nahi to minus. Suppose in front of this we have the plus. Yes, plus. So we are writing here what? Minus, minus. So this is known as what? Adjoint of a matrix. Yes, for the 2 by 2, for the 3 by 3. So we will see some examples. See, example 23. So find adjoint A for A is equal to matrix is having 2, 3, 1, 4. This is actually 2 by 2 matrix. Yes or no? So now observe here. Given matrix is we are taking here A is equal to 2, 3, 1, 4. Yes or no? So observe, I am giving already directions here. Remember. So this is, we just observe here. This is the 2 by 2 matrix. Yes or no? For the 2 by 2 matrix, suppose if you are finding the adjoint A, so just interchange these two places. Yes? Just interchange these two places. Means interchange is nothing but in place of 4 we are writing 2, in place of 2 we are writing 4. That's all. 4, 2. Yes? Next one is, after changing these two places, interchanging these two places, just in these two places, just we are going to put the negative sign. There is a positive sign now, so we are writing there what? Negative sign, minus 3, minus 1. That's all. This is nothing but adjoint of a matrix. It is a very simple one. Suppose he is giving the matrix is a 2 by 2 matrix. How to find the adjoint is nothing but by interchanging these two places, and the second way is by changing the sign of these two elements. So that is nothing but what? Adjoint of a matrix. Yes, I will tell you one more time. जब ये मैट्रिक्स है इसे मैं अर्जेंट फाइंड कर रहा हूँ तो ये दोनों प्लेसेस को आप कब इंटरचेंज करो, इंटरचेंज का मतलब एक दूसरे के प्लेस में बिठा दो, 4 के प्लेस पे 2, 2 के प्लेस पे 4 हो गया। ये दोनों के सामने सर नेगेटिव साइन लगा दो, जब पॉजिटिव साइन है तो नेगेटिव, जब नेगेटिव है तो पॉजिटिव, बट इसका मतलब चेंज साइन है, साइन का मतलब प्लस में तो माइनस, इधर दोनों के सामने पॉजिटिव तो दोनों के सामने नेगेटिव, दिस इज नथिंग बट व्हाट ऑर्डिनेट पे ये सब कुछ इज गिवन द मैट्रिक्स इज 2x2। नेक्स्ट सी हियर देयर इज वन ऑफ द थ्योरम, इफ ए बी एनी गिवन स्क्वायर मैट्रिक्स ऑफ ऑर्डर n, ये ऐसा एक मैट्रिक्स है कि उसका ऑर्डर क्या है सर n है, ओके, देन ए इनटू ऑर्डिनेट इज इक्वल टू ऑर्डिनेट इनटू ए इज इक्वल टू n है डिटरमिनेंट ऑफ ए इनटू i, यस a into adjoint is equal to adjoint a into a is equal to determinant of a into i। तो यहाँ पे जो आप लोग formula याद रख रहे हैं पे क्या बोलते हैं, a into adjoint a क्या बन सकता है सर, बोलते हैं adjoint a into a भी बन सकता, adjoint a into a also we can say what determinant of a into i, yes a into adjoint a also equal to determinant of a into i, remember this is the very important one, yes ये formula याद रखना चाहिए आप लोगों को, a into adjoint a is equal to what determinant of a into i, okay, so next one is what adjoint a into a is equal to what is that determinant of a into i, this is the one more formula from this one we are writing first, so a into adjoint a is equal to what determinant of a into i, okay, so adjoint a into a is equal to determinant of a into i, okay, by taking the matrix shape also we can prove this formula, yes, so now where see here I is nothing but it is the identity matrix of order again what n, I is nothing but here what identity matrix whose order is what I, yes, so we will see some examples, see, so now we will discuss singular matrix and non singular matrix, yes, what is singular matrix and what is non singular matrix, suppose we are taking a square matrix, yeah, is said to be a singular, there is one of these square matrix is having, yes, by taking that square matrix I am going to say that matrix is a square singular matrix, when we can say that matrix is a singular matrix means there is one condition, what is the condition, that matrix should be whose determinant is equal to what zero, if you are going to say the matrix is a singular matrix, when we can say the matrix is a singular matrix means whose determinant should be what equal to 0, yes, so we will see one of the example, A is equal to having 1, 2, 4, 8, yes, whether it is a square matrix or not, yes sir it is a square matrix, by going to say this matrix is a singular matrix, first we have to check the determinant of this matrix whether given the result is 0 or not, suppose the determinant of this matrix which is given the result is 0, remember this matrix is said to be what singular matrix, yes, so now I will see that we know that how to make a determinant of A is equal to determinant of 1, 2, 4, 8, yes, this is the 2 by 2 matrix, just make a cross multiplication, 1 into 8 is 8 minus 4 to the 8, 8 minus 8 is 0, so determinant of A we got from here what 0, so we got the determinant of A is 0, means that matrix is known as what singular matrix, it is a very simple definition, okay, if I am giving one of the matrix, suppose the matrix is a square matrix, suppose if you are finding the determinant of that matrix, if you got the determinant of that matrix equal to 0, then that matrix is known as what singular matrix, that's all, yes, so we will see the non-singular matrix, what is the non-singular matrix, a square matrix is said to be a non-singular matrix, if you are having a square matrix, if you are going to say that the matrix is a non-singular matrix, say again there is a condition, what is the condition, that condition is if we are taking the square matrix, if I am going to say that matrix is a singular matrix means whose determinant should not equal to 0, yes, in the singular matrix determinant is equal to 0, in a non-singular matrix determinant not equal to 0, yes, there is a little bit of difference is having, in a singular matrix determinant is equal to 0, in a non-singular matrix determinant not equal to 0, if we are having the matrix here, yes, now we will check this matrix is a non-singular matrix or not, how we can check, again we have to find the determinant, we know that how to find the determinant, the cross multiplication of this one will be 4 minus 3 to the 6, we got minus 2, The determinant of this square matrix we got here minus 2 is nothing but whether it is equal to 0, minus 2 whether it is equal to 0, so no, minus 2 which is not equal to 0. So that's why I am writing minus 2 not equal to 0. Finally we got the determinant of this is not equal to 0. If the determinant of this square matrix is not equal to 0, we can say the matrix is what? Non-singular matrix. Yes, this is the difference between singular and non-singular matrix. Okay, we will see next concept. See, this is the one of the important notes. So actually this note we can use in the JEE and CET. Yes, so this is not more effective in NCERT board. Yes, see here, A is square matrix of order n. We are taking one of the matrix, that is what, it is a square matrix and order is we are taking n. Okay, then determinant of A is equal to determinant of adjoint A is equal to determinant of A whole power n minus 1. Yes, this is the formula. So when we are writing this formula, suppose having the order of that matrix is n. Yes, if I am going to say the matrix whose order is having 3. Yes, if matrix whose order is having 3, what is the formula we can write? It is very simple. Determinant of adjoint A is equal to determinant of A in place of n, we have to replace the word 3. So we got the determinant of adjoint A is equal to, remember that is determinant of A whole square. Yes, determinant of adjoint A is equal to determinant of A whole square. When we are writing determinant of A whole square means, suppose the matrix will order is what, having 3. Yes, then the determinant of A is whole square. The adjoint of A is equal to, we can write determinant of A whole square. Yes, so this is the formula and all of you remember this formula, that's all. Yes, so now inverse of a matrix, we know that one of the formula here, see, this is the formula. A into adjoint A is equal to what? Determinant of A into I. Yes or no? A into adjoint A is equal to determinant of A into I. So now I will write here from this, by sending this n right hand side, by taking determinant of n left hand side. This is the determinant of A which is multiplying with identity matrix. Yes or no? So that's why I am taking here, by taking this on left hand side. So determinant of A which is left hand side means adjoint, it can be written as adjoint A by determinant of A. Yes sir. See, this is the example 24. Yes, it is an important one. So in this, actually we have to find the determinant of A, adjoint of A and inverse of A matrix A. Yes. So now see, so what is given? If A is a matrix having, then verify that, what we have to verify? A into adjoint A is equal to determinant of A into I. Yes, also find A inverse. So in this, we have to verify A into adjoint A is equal to determinant of A into I or not. Yes, then also we have to find from this A inverse. Yes, first we can verify this. Before that, observe here. So in this, having the determinant of A na, so first we can find the determinant of A. Sir, why we are finding the first determinant of A, we say, remember. So in this also we have to find A inverse na. Yes, to find the inverse, first we have to check the matrix A whose determinant is 0 or not equal to 0. Because of, suppose the matrix whose determinant is equal to 0, remember, so inverse is not exist. Yes, so that's why first we can check the determinant of A. So we are taking the matrix here, we are finding the determinant, this is actually 3 by 3 matrix. Yes, so we know that how to find the order of the, how to find the determinant for the matrix, suppose which is given the order is 3 by 3. Because of we have completed in the first exercise so many questions there. Yes. So now here, first we have to write plus minus plus. Yes. We are taking the plus minus plus means this is the first row, in this we are taking. Okay. Suppose if you want to continue the determinant along the second row, along the third row, or first column, second column, third column. Okay. As you will wish. So now here, we are taking the first row. Yes. So now by taking the first row, so just you have to write here 1, 1 into, close the address of 1 here. Yes, by closing the address of 1, whatever the elements we are observing here, na, they are what? 4, 3, 3, 4. Yes, next one is what? Minus 3. Minus 3 to again close the address of this. By closing the address of minus 3, that is the first to second column, whatever the elements we are observing here, 1, 3, 1, 4. 1, 3, 1, 4. Next one is what? Plus 3 into, we will write here. Yes, 1, 4, 1, 3. Yes, 1, 4, 1, 3.
Next, when taking the cross multiplication of this one, we can have 4 into 4, that is what, 16. So by making the cross multiplication of these two elements, so immediately you have to write the minus. Then 3 into 3 is what? 9. So that's the right. You get 16 minus 9. Minus 3 into, again make the cross multiplication, 4 minus 3, that is here. And plus 3 into again what? 3 minus 4. 3 minus 4. We got here. So next, 16 minus 9 is 7. 4 minus 3 is 1. 3 minus 4 is minus 1. Yes? 7. Minus 3, this is plus into minus again what? Minus 3. 7. So this is the minus 3 minus 3. Yes, in front of these two numbers, having the negative sign means we are adding these two. Yes or no? So minus 3 is minus 6. So 7 minus 6, it can be written as what? 1. Yes? So by getting the 1 here, means we can say which is not equal to 0. So we can say determinant of A which is not equal to 0. Yes, after having this, now we have to find the adjoint of A. Yes? So we got the determinant of A. Now we can find the adjoint of A. Yes, just I will do this. See, this is the having here. Already we have completed the determinant of A. So now, so we can find the adjoint of A. Yes, how to find the adjoint of A? So we know that one of the way by taking the matrix A, again we are finding the cofactors and we can form the cofactor matrix. Again we are making the transpose of the cofactor matrix, then you will figure the adjoint of A. Okay, no need to do those total parts. Okay, simply I will tell this one of the shortcut. By taking the shortcut also you can apply in SLT. Yes, no need to get confusion. This shortcut we can use in the JEE mains, also we can use in the NCERT board also. Okay, so how I am writing to find the adjoint A means, just observe here. First we have to take the matrix A. In this, see, in the second row we have to take the middle element. Yes, in the second row we are taking what? Middle element, that is 4. Yes, so then we have to write 3. Again we have to come at 1 and the last we have to come at 4. Yes, means we are going to start with the 4 and we are going to jump into the right, again left, again we are coming to middle. Yes, so generally this method we can write center, right, left, center. So just like remember like this, CRLC. Yes, what is it? CRLC means center, right, left, center. Yes, see here, 4, 3, 1, 4. Yes, but this is actually horizontal now. So, but we have to write in a vertical, remember that. Where we are writing? We are writing in a vertical. 4, then 3, again 1, again 4. This is the confusion which is here. I will tell you. First, second row lena chahiye. Isme middle element se start karo. Ye middle element ke paas bas kya hai? 3 likhna, right hand side. Baad mein se left aao, baad mein se middle. Yes, itna hi kaam karna. Lekin kaisa likhna? Horizontal nahi, vertical likho. Yani vertical hai. 4, 3, 1, next 4. Completed. Again, R3. Yes. So again middle one. 3, 4, 1, 3. इतना काम करने का. Next. Again first one. पहले middle से start करो. Then third one. Then first one. Yes. Next. 3, 3, 1, 3. Yes. Middle से start करो. Right, left, middle. Complete हो गया. Middle, right, left, middle. देखो. 3, 3, 1, 3. ये 3 rows लिखने के बाद vertical में जो स्टार्टिंग में है सर, ये फिर से स्टार्टिंग में है सर, सर फिर से यहाँ पे लिखना चाहिए. कहाँ पे? लास्ट में लिखना चाहिए. स्टार्टिंग एंड लास्ट बताओ, एंडिंग दोनों सेम रहना चाहिए. लिखिए, अभी क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई करो, टोटल को मैं क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई करो. यस, तो क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई करके यहाँ पे लिखना चाहिए. अभी बन गया अडजॉइंट ए. तो यहाँ पे क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई करके कैसा लिखना चाहिए, ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. 4 4 16 माइनस देखो 3 3 9. जो भी मैं यहाँ पे डायरेक्शन बता रहा हूँ, तीन दोनों के एक तीन चार एलिमेंट्स के बीच में क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई करना, वैसा ही होगा. इधर लिख लो 4 4 16 माइनस 3 3 9. कंप्लीटेड. नेक्स्ट 3 3 9 माइनस 4 3 12. कंप्लीटेड. नेक्स्ट 3 3 9 माइनस 3 4 12. यस, कंप्लीट हो गया. नेक्स्ट यहाँ पे अभी ये फर्स्ट रो कंप्लीट हो गया. सेकंड रो लिखना होगा तो ये दो एलिमेंट, 3 1 3 माइनस 1 इंटू 4 इज 4. नेक्स्ट 4 ones are 4 minus 1 into 3 is 3. Next 3 ones are 3 minus 1 into 3 is 3. Yes, I am completing. Last one is 1 into 3 is 3 minus 4 into 1 is 4. Next 1 into 3 is 3 minus 3 into 1 is 3. Yes, next 1 into 4 is 4 minus 3 into 1 is 3. ये लिखने को आता होगा ज्यादा टफ होगा मुझे बताओ. Yes, ये आपने कंप्लीट हो गया. ये तो सिंप्लीफिकेशन मालूम है. 16 minus 9 7 minus 3 minus 3 minus 1 1 0. Yes, minus 1 1 0 1. This is the alternative. ये आप लोग ऑर्डिनेट फाइंड करने का तरीका. ज्यादा कंफ्यूजन कुछ भी नहीं है. फर्स्ट वी हैव टू टेक द मैट्रिक्स ए. यस, वी हैव टू टेक अगेन द सेकंड रो इन दैट सेंटर एलिमेंट. देन वी हैव टू जंप इन टू द राइट, अगेन जंप इन टू द लेफ्ट, अगेन वी हैव टू कम एट सेंटर. यस, दैट्स ऑल. अब फर्स्ट वी हैव राइट द मिडिल रो. यस, एंड लास्ट रो. देन वी हैव टू गो फर्स्ट रो अगेन मिडिल रो. यस, दैट्स ऑल. So next to see, after having the originality, so what we have to verify, we have to take A into originality. Yes, A into originality is equal to, I will write, A is a matrix already having here, into originality. Originality is nothing but C. A is a matrix, again I am writing the originality. Already having the originality here, yes or no? There is originality. Now, after writing this, we know that how to multiply the two matrices, yes or no? So, how we can multiply? First row, first column. Yes, we are writing the first row, first column here. See, 1 into 7 is 7 plus 3 into minus 1 is minus 1. 3 into minus 1 again minus 1. This is the way we are multiplying the first row, first column. Yes, again we have to take the first row. Again we have to multiply with the second column. See, this is the second column or not. Again, by taking the first row, multiply with the last column. Yes, so we have completed. Again we are taking the second row, we are multiplying with the first column. Yes, again we are taking the second row, we are multiplying with the second column. Yeah, this one. Again we are taking the first row, we are second row, we are multiplying with what? Which column? That is last column. Yes, we are writing here. Next one is, by taking the last row, we have to multiply with the first column. This is nothing but what? Last row, first column. This is nothing but what? Last row, second column. This is last row, third column. Yes, so we are going to multiply like this. Yes, you people already advanced in that how to multiply the two matrices. Yes or no? After multiplying, do the simplification. 1 into 7 is 7, plus and minus is minus 3, again plus and minus, minus 3. Yes, again here also, minus, plus and minus, minus 3. You people know already this is a like LKG A concept. Yes or no? Because of in LKG we can learn, yes, A bar happened, B bar was like that. So here also, 1 into 7 is nothing but 7. ये तो छोटे बच्चे को किया था, प्लस इंटू माइनस माइनस थ्री ऑन द थ्री. ये तो आप लोग लिख सकते सर, ये क्या बड़ी बात नहीं. यस, तो यहाँ पे जो है आफ्टर दिस वी आर राइटिंग दिस मैट्रिक्स. यस, आफ्टर राइटिंग दिस मैट्रिक्स नाउ जस्ट वी हैव टू सिंप्लीफाई दिस मैट्रिक्स. यस, नाउ वी कैन सिंप्लीफाई दिस मैट्रिक्स. सेवन माइनस थ्री इट कैन बी रिटन एज माइनस सिक्स. And minus 3 plus 3 gets cancelled. The result is what? 0. Again, this is nothing but what? Minus 3 plus 3 gets cancelled. 0. Yes or no? And here, I am writing. So after writing this, we are having here, the matrix is 7 minus 6 is 1. 0, 0. Yes or no? And this is again 0. 1, 0. And this is again 0. 0, 0, 1. Yes? By observing this matrix, so 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Which kind of matrix you are going to see this? Sir, this is actually what? Identity matrix. Yes or no? So just I will draw this. Yes. So then I will explain. See. So we got already 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Yes. So which kind of matrix is this? This is actually identity matrix. Or we can say unit matrix. Yes or no? So now we can write this matrix as, now we got the result of which one? We got the result of A into originality is equal to identity matrix. Yes or no? So I am writing here A into originality we got finally here, that is 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Yes or no? So now from this also we can write some 1 into identity matrix. Yes or no? By multiplying with 1 into identity matrix, again we are having the result is identity matrix or not? Yes, sir. Okay, so now one into identity matrix is again we are having the identity matrix. Which one is the identity matrix? Yes, this is the identity matrix. Yes or no? So now I will write one into identity matrix. Again, we get this matrix only because of this is the identity matrix. Now what is one here? One is nothing but we got the determinant of A is equal to one. So that's why that is this of one is determinant of A into identity matrix. Yes, we have to verify this one only. See once again. A into ordinate A is equal to what? Determinant of A into I. Yes, we got now. So we have right here. Hence, verified. Yes, so we will find the A inverse. See, so this is, we are finding the A inverse. Yes, A inverse is equal to 1 by determinant of A into ordinate. Yes, so now this is the formula we are finding the A inverse, 1 by determinant of A into adjoint. Yes or no? So 1 by determinant of A is actually regarding what? 1. Yes, just now we have completed now. So adjoint A. Also we have completed adjoint A. This is the adjoint matrix. Yes or no? So 1 into this matrix, again you get the same matrix. This is the way we are finding the A inverse. Yes, this is nothing but A inverse. A inverse is nothing but what? 1 by determinant of A into adjoint A. Yes, to find the A inverse, remember one thing, in the advanced leap, we have to find the determinant of A. Again, we have to find their what? Adjoint of A. Yes or no? We have to find determinant of A, adjoint A. We got already determinant of A and as well as adjoint A. Just we are going to put the adjoint, determinant of A and adjoint A in this. Whatever the resulting matrix we are having now, that matrix is known as what? Inverse of a matrix A. As we can denote like this, A inverse. Yes? So we have completed the example 24 here. So we can continue the remaining questions tomorrow. Thank you.